So there's a really small, lightweight, inexpensive, durable survival item that I've never seen anybody talk about putting into a survival kit, and especially for the purpose that I want to talk to you about today. So let's get to that right now. Some of the items that you will find, especially in the fall of the year, you'll find various kinds of nuts, hickory nuts, walnuts, and things that you can harvest as wild edibles. And they're very good for you, walnuts in particular, very healthy fats, and things that are kind of difficult sometimes to get in the wilderness. And so getting into these nuts can be a bit of a problem. Now, if you've got a heavy-duty steel nutcracker like this one, then you're in pretty good shape. You could just take the nut and you find the appropriate position when it's opened, push the lever down, and you have enough leverage that you can very easily crack that nut. But of course, this is heavy. This is meant for home use, and you might even drill holes and bolt this down to a larger board, etc. So this is a great item. You can get this at Lehman's, but again, you're not going to have it with you when you're in a survival situation. What you will often find in a survival situation are rocks, and you want to look around and find one that fits your palm good, be a good hammer stone. Sometimes it'll have a more of a flat surface on one side that works just perfect with your right hand or left hand, and you can take this, of course, and no big mystery, you can just crack that nut with it. All right, now, the problem that we have with a lot of these is you could easily smash this completely using a heavy hammer stone like this. But we don't really want to do that because, again, we don't want to crush the meat in the nut here. We don't want to lose any of that valuable food that we might have and the fats that's contained in it. One solution is this nut pick. And you can find these stores, stainless steel, they're not that big, and in a larger kit, this would be an ideal item. However, what if you have a smaller kit that you want to carry around with you? I would recommend getting some finish nails. Now, this one is a steel finish nail, and this one is stainless steel. Obviously, stainless steel is going to be better. This is going to rust, and this isn't going to fit in a very small kit. So, I've used these since I was a kid. We used to have a lot of hickory nuts around, and I would go into our garage and I would use the big shop vise. I would place the nut in there, I would crank the handle around until it would crack, and I always put my hand around it so that it didn't fly everywhere when I was cracking it open, and then we would use nails to dig out the meat out of the nut. And of course, this works absolutely perfectly because you can get in here with the tip and you can just dig that out so very well. And if you work at it carefully, you can get it out without damaging or destroying too much of the value, just down in there like this, and begin to pry it out and right into your palm. And of course, the more you go, the deeper you get, the better off you'll be as far as getting out larger and larger pieces of that precious commodity that we all need, which is food in the backcountry. Once you dig out what you can get, you can take your hammer stone, you can crack it again, and then you can access the food. And this will fit in a tiny Altoids kit. As a matter of fact, you can see here in my kit, underneath my bright guitar pick, I have one right here. And it just fits in there perfectly. Doesn't take up hardly any room. And even though this kit was packed pretty full, there was plenty of room to insert that small, thin finish nail. Perfect size, and now I have an additional means of getting food when I'm in the backcountry, especially in the fall time of the year, but at any time it's good to have a nail. Again, you can hammer it into a tree, hang stuff on it. It's just a nice resource. It allows you to get down into these small grooves down here in the nut and work those out. What I often do is I take my nail and go ahead and scrape out these little pieces, and you'll find that they will stick pretty well to the nail and just use it as a little fork to eat off of. There you go. And it's something you can do in the evening after you've harvested all day, you're sitting in your shelter at night, cracking open some of these nuts, and just get it out. And there you have it. Completely clean. All of the nut out. We didn't crush it. We didn't break it. Just broke it into a few pieces. And use this extremely valuable resource, this tiny nail, to help us get our food and to harvest it properly. This is an invaluable tool. When you get into the fall, you start harvesting wild nuts, you'll really like having one of these along. And there's the end result. The nuts picked completely clean, and it was delicious. This is James Bender for Waypoint Survival. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. Also, make sure and check out the links in the description box below. And while you're down there, you'll find our Patreon link. This is where you can donate to financially support the channel. And you can do so for as little as $1 a month. And a big thank you to everybody that's been doing so. You'll also find our Spring link. This is where you can buy great Waypoint Survival branded merchandise. You'll also find our waypointsurvival.com link. And this is where you can sign up for great survival and bushcraft training classes. And if you haven't done so already, please subscribe to the channel. We'd really appreciate it. And when you do subscribe, make sure and press that bell button so that you can stay notified of all of our upcoming videos. And we'll talk to you next time.